Hello and welcome to Demo Reel. As always, I'm your host Nearphotison, and we're playing on the Xbox 360 this week. We had almost a month's worth of PlayStation 2 content off just one disc, but now we're back on the 360. Looks like there's a trailer at the start of this one. I'm going to go ahead and skip it. It's Halo 3 trailer. So let's take a look at what we've got on this disc. Under playable demos, we've got Lost Planet, and then Lost Planet Debriefing, which is looks like a feedback form for it, and then Perfect Dark Zero, FIFA 06 World Cup, and then also for some reason a debriefing on the FIFA game, which is a little weird. This disc has under features a bunch of videos that are like, I don't know what these are exactly. I think they're trying to be like more entertaining ways of promoting these games, but I don't know exactly how these work, but they're videos, so they're not something we're going to be doing here this week. In the Spring Showcase, there's also a bunch of videos, just a ton of video content on this. Some of these I wouldn't mind playing. We haven't played a few of these. And then under Video Showcase, there's Prey, which I don't know why it's separate from everything else. So we'll go ahead and go into playable demos here and do this Lost Planet one. Capcom's brand new Xbox 360 exclusive is one explosive game, and we have the demo to prove it. Non-stop action, gorgeous animation, and a huge icy world await. So, here we go. And, you may know a little bit about this game. I think this is probably the same demo we've played of Lost Planet before. We played it for a long time before, so if it is, we may not even do the first mission, because there was, as I recall, two different storylines you could do. One where you fought mostly bugs, and then one where you fought humans. And we played the one where you fought the aliens for a really long time. And we played the human one a little bit less. Let's see. It's the E3-06 demo, so it might be different. No, this looks pretty much the same. Okay, breach the defense wall and hammer the leader's verses. Okay, so yeah, we'll just do this one. Okay. So, yeah, I remember this pretty well. It wasn't that long ago we played the other demo of this. Basically, the premise of the game is that you are on an icy planet, and there's, like, pirates, and also evil alien bugs, and you fight them. That's really it. We're not doing so great here this time. We actually did a little bit better before, probably because we'd been fighting the bugs for so long, so we had a little bit of practice. When you defeat enemies, they drop heat, which you need. If you don't have heat, eventually, I guess you freeze to death, I assume. So it's kind of like a secondary health. This is the game. I don't know. I feel like I don't have a lot to add to this, and it's not really necessarily how I would have chosen to start this episode. I'm mostly playing this for the Perfect Dark Zero, but also just because it seemed like a pretty relaxing way to come down off of a very long disc that we just finished, and I don't expect this one will take nearly as long. I was shooting at that robot there, but I don't think I got it. There are giant mechs in the game too. Again, if you didn't see that episode, I don't remember offhand. I probably should have looked before I started playing. I don't remember if what episode that was, but it wasn't that long ago that we played this, and we played the bug infiltration mission too. We might do a little bit of that this time, just so you don't have to see that other video to see the other mission. But kind of like how that time we played the bug one for a long time and then came into this for like a couple minutes, I think we'll probably have an inverse situation here. Keep hitting this, whoa, jeez. I just want to get over this fence, because I didn't mean to come up here, but... Oh, is there somebody... There's some people shooting at me up here, aren't there? Okay, there we go, we can take these guys down. I did not even see them up here when I came over. This is where we are. I don't have a whole lot to say about games like this. I do like that this one at least has a different feel than a lot of the shooter games we've played. Like the icy planet and the sci-fi setting do help it a lot, separate it from like regular military games. But there we go. That hurt my ears. We finished that pretty quickly, just because I'm bad at that. We'll play the high infiltration for a little bit, but I don't expect to play it for like 20 or 30 minutes like we did before, probably just another 5 or so, just to get a feel for it. But yeah, we started out here, and as I recall, there was some bugs that came down around this way. In that episode, we, like I said, we got really far. I think we got all the way to the final boss of the demo. And then I got killed by the final boss because I just wasn't prepared for it. It was a lot harder than the rest of the enemies we had faced. Being a boss, it's not surprising, of course. But I don't think I was fully prepared for it. It was rolling around a lot. By the time I figured out how I was even supposed to fight it, it was too late. I think I need to get inside of a mech, don't I? Wasn't there a big mech thing I got inside before? I'm trying really hard to remember exactly what we did. So right now we're doing nothing. Oh, here we go. There's some bugs. I just remember piloting one of the giant robots for a while before getting back on foot. But these guys are a lot easier to kill off than the humans are. Mostly because they don't have guns, I guess. But yeah, you can. But like the humans, they drop energy or heat or whatever whenever you kill them. That you can collect. Kind of need. There we go. Yeah. They also freeze up and die when you, like, they turn solid ice when you kill them, like with Sub-Zero or something. But that's just how cold the Lost Planet is, you know? But I'm trying to remember where exactly that mech was, because it'd be cool to get it. I think it was over here somewhere, maybe? I don't know, I see more, like, wreckage, but I don't see anything that looks like a mech. Which is all I really want right now. Oh well. I guess maybe we can't get it. I don't remember where it was. I'm pretty sure I remember playing against one. Or playing with one, I mean. Oh, am I out of bullets? Shoot. It's bad. Hold on. We need to... There's a gun over here we can pick up, I think. That'll help. Somebody dropped it here, I guess. Okay. There, we got a few more bullets now. So we need to shoot at the yellow sack here. Pretty sure that's its weak point. Oh, and it gets stuck when it attacks. I didn't remember that. It's just like burrowing now, okay. I don't know how hurt we made it. I'm sure it'll pop back up here any second though. We can deal with it then. In the meantime, we've still got lots of these guys lying around too. Or I don't remember. Do I need to like destroy some of these like holes that they're coming out of? I don't remember if I can. They don't seem to be getting hurt when I shoot at them. But it also looks like maybe most of them stop. So let's see, where is the little mini boss guy? Did he leave? I guess so, I don't see it anymore. Okay. I don't know where to go now. I really don't remember this as well as I thought I did. I remember the later parts of the demo a lot better, once we started getting into some different environments when it wasn't just snow everywhere. Which is another nice thing I have to say about the game, even though, again, it's not really my thing. I don't think any game where you shoot people with machine guns is really my game. But I do think that this one's pretty well done. And like, there's some different environments. You can go into buildings, there's some research facilities you fight inside, and some of the underground caves are pretty cool. That's actually my favorite part, is when you go underground and there's all these bat-like aliens flying around, and eventually we end up fighting the big roly-poly boss that killed us. I really have no idea where I'm going now. We might just go ahead and call it quits there. You guys got to see some of the aliens. I wish I could remember which episode it was we played this on before. But anyway, yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and quit. We've got some more games to play, and I don't want to spend all day on this. So let's go ahead and back out. Next up here we have Perfect Dark Zero. If you missed out on this slick Xbox 360 FPS, now's the time for a little makeup play session. Sharp graphics and shoot, duck, and cover gameplay combine beautifully for unique experience. And I'm a little bit familiar with Perfect Dark. I'm trying to remember if we've played it on Demo Reel. We've played so many different FPS games, and I'm not like super familiar with this one either. I'm liking this little developer graphic though. I like the little Oh, it's Rare. Okay, I hadn't seen that for Rare before, but I'm not like super familiar with their games either. Oh, and now. Okay, now we're in the game. Okay, I was trying to figure out if that was another developer logo or what, but no, we're in, getting into Perfect Dark here, looking at our protagonist there and some gun pointing. It's not telling us a whole lot yet, but I guess we can know that there are guns in it. This is good, good thing to know. And hovercrafts, which is actually that's pretty cool. I'm trying to figure out what exactly it's trying to tell us here. Like, can we, like, modify and customize these vehicles and guns and stuff, or is it just being gimmicky? I don't know. It's flying us around here. Oh. I guess all we need to know is that there's a girl with, and there are guns and vehicles, and that's probably all the target audience for this game cares about. But, so... This, if we have played a Perfect Dark game, and I don't know if there's more than one or not, like I said, I'm not really familiar with it. But I know we haven't played Perfect Dark Zero. This is definitely new. I'm pretty sure I'd remember, if we played a demo with this video on it. But even regardless of that, I don't remember playing anything with this character. But I do recognize her now that I see her. I didn't have an image in my head for Perfect Dark, when I read that it was on the disc. I just recognized the name and thought we should play that. Once I saw her briefly in the video, she was mostly a silhouette through most of that. But once I saw her, I was like, oh yeah, I remember seeing her on, like, a game box. So we've got missions, a combat arena, and options. This is, I wonder if the combat arena is just multiplayer. I'm guessing from the controllers that's showing up there that, it is. We want to do a solo agent here. If I had someone with me, we'd do a cooperative and maybe try out the arena, but we don't. I might, if we have time, depending on how long this looks to be, I might check out the arena just to see if we can do like some kind of battle against the computer. But in the meantime, we'll try out the mission thing. This is probably what most of the game is built around. So, the PDZ story mode demo. Okay, have to do an escort. Get information from start. There's waypoint arrows. Okay. So, alright, seems pretty straightforward, I guess. We'll, move along here. I don't know, am I supposed to be hiding? Everyone else is hiding. Are there enemies here? I don't see anybody. I hear noises. Okay. Oh, is that her name? Up the valley. They're trying to reinforce the outpost. Get a firing line. We can take them out from here. Okay, you don't have to yell at me. All right. Okay. Well, wait, how many people do I have to shoot? Do I have to shoot anybody? Because they're like, I've got all these people doing it for me. I have a gun and I can help, but like, I don't think I contributed to that guy up there that was firing at us dying at all. I might have hit him once. But it seemed like my team had it pretty well covered. Okay. Where am I going? What am I doing? I don't see any of these waymarks. I do see that I'm being shot at, though. Okay, can I cover? I saw a cover option. Anyway, I got him. I don't know. It said press A to cover, but then... Oh, come on. Okay. Well, when it says that, I press A and nothing happens, so I guess I'm not actually... Oh, we didn't ambush the convoy? Okay. I don't know what I did wrong. Was I supposed to be shooting at that flying thing more? I don't know. Or were we supposed to not be spotted? Is that it? And because somebody saw us? I don't know. I don't know what to do. Hey, okay. Got that guy. Oh hey, somebody on our level.
Hey, you should have took the headshot.
Oh, okay. I guess I should have took the headshot. I was stopping for a second because I wasn't positive he was an enemy. Like, he shot at me. But for some reason, he looked like, the guys we were running with to me. And he was the first enemy we'd encountered on the same, like, level. Everyone else has been either way above or way below us. Oh, wait, okay, that one's not an enemy. I need to pay attention to the crosshair colors. That's what I need to be doing. Okay, let's, we'll take cover here in the light. I can't see where these bullets are coming from. Somebody's shooting at us, I guess. That guy? Probably? Okay. I'm just running and shooting. That's all I know how to do in these games. Okay. I don't know if I'm even going the right way, honestly. Oh no, I'm out of bullets! I did not notice. Oh no. Okay. Hey, give me your bullets. Or your gun. Just give me your gun. Okay, that'll work. Hey, you shooting my buddy? Guy in dark? Okay. Let's see. Oh, wait, I see a health bar. Is there... Am I supposed to be shooting... What is the health bar for? I don't know. I tried to see if I had, like, a grenade or something, because I wanted to shoot this truck some more. I don't know what the health... I'm assuming the health bar is to, like, a vehicle or something, but I don't know. Like, again, I'm not positive, but I think we might have been supposed to shoot down that airship that was coming in. But I'm not certain. I'm not really certain at all of anything. Oh, come on, I'm out of bullets again? Wait, now I'm not. Great, I am blind. Okay. Probably, I think I shot some of my own people there. They blinded me, it was so bright. Okay. Can we get up here? Okay. I don't know where. I don't know what I'm doing, obviously. I'm just wandering around shooting at random people. Hey! Speaking of whom, there's a random people right there. If I can reload. Alright, there we go. Okay. So, I got some ammo. Oh, hey, there's some way markers. Okay, I saw them there. I think that's the first time I've noticed them. If they've been showing them before, I didn't see them. I don't know why I was expecting them to be easier to spot, but there's, like, just slightly lighter blue than the ground is. Okay. So, we made it through all that firefighting. I was barely paying attention to all that when it was happening, but... come on. Okay. Did he say not bad for a girl? Did he seriously say that? That's what I heard. I don't know. What a jerk. I guess I'm happy I shot him. He's a sexist. Chauvinist guy. Okay. Hold on, don't shoot at me while I'm shooting you. Oh, did we lose one of our teammates? Oh no. I was starting to wonder if they were immortal, but obviously not. Okay. I'm not ready for this. I'm not ready for this right now. Stop it. I can't see anything. Okay, just shooting at people. I'm not doing a whole lot of the covering that I'm supposed to be doing. So it was something it advertised in the description. I'm not doing a lot of that. I'm not doing really a lot of shooting either. Like, I'm firing my gun a lot. I'm not shooting very many people. Okay. Let's see. There's still more guys around here. This guy's got his little shield. It doesn't seem to help a whole lot, though, does it? Oh! I did a thing! Okay. Oh, that's cute. Okay, I don't know if you guys can read that, but I like the "you will tell your friends about this demo with genuine excitement" at the end. This message is rated something deniable. Okay. Well, so hold on. I can I go back? Mission select. Is that what I wanted? No. No, I want to go to... Okay. I want to go all the way back to combat arena and see if I can do this. We'll just... Let's see. We'll do a private game, I guess. And the rest are all bots? Okay. Yeah, that's what I wanted to see. Alright, so it looks like we can play this. So let's do it. Okay. Yeah, we'll just do this real quick. Just see what the combat arena is like. I imagine it's like the mission, except you're shooting everybody. It didn't look like there was teams... but I could be mistaken about that. Maybe we'll be split into teams once we're in there. But, yeah, it looks like it could be kind of fun. Okay, so playing a game of infection. I don't know what that means. I see lots of dots on the screen that are green. Does that mean they're on my team? Nope. Somebody shot me. Okay. I don't know. Okay, I don't know what's happening. I don't know what purchase time means. I noticed there's a skeleton. Okay, I'm infected. What does that mean? Okay, so I switched teams? Is that what happened? Okay. So now I'm shooting at the humans and I'm a skeleton. This is cool. I like being a skeleton. I don't know about the rest of it, but I like being a skeleton a lot. Okay, I'm down here. Somebody's shooting at me. Okay, so now that I'm a dead skeleton, do I become a human? No, I'm still a skeleton. What? I don't understand how it works. Because then, won't the skeletons just always have the advantage? I don't know, but look at how cool I am. I'm a skeleton. I like this so much. I just want to run around as a skeleton. I don't care about shooting people. Look at this. Okay, oh! I spoke too soon. Wait, where'd they go? I can't see anything. Alright. I got this Reg over here who's a bot. Okay, I think they're still alive. Or maybe. I don't know. Where'd they go? Oh, hey! There's a person. I'm shooting them, but they don't seem to care. I think I'm out of bullets. Okay. I keep doing that. Oh, I headshotted. I did a headshot, guys! Isn't that cool? Oh, speaking of which, there I go. Oh, no! Oh! Oh, I got killed by a pimple. Okay. This is fun. I don't have any idea what's going on, and I don't really care about accomplishing anything. But I like being a skeleton with a gun. That's all I know. Let's see. I'm having fun. Being a skeleton makes it so much more entertaining to me. Oh, something's blowing up down there. Look at that. There's a skeleton floating on the river. Okay, so, yeah, so, I guess what was the other game mode? I don't even remember what it said. So it was Infection and then, something else. Oh, hello. I did not see you. It was too perfectly dark here. Zero. Okay. Let's see. Still not doing too hot here. Okay. There's too many people. They're all shooting me. Stop it. I'm dead again! How do you keep killing the skeleton? Oh, I like the falling animation, too. It's always fun watching the skeleton die. Oh, okay. So I guess, okay, you just have to try to survive the whole time? Okay, let's go back. No, I want to exit. Okay, I want to see if I can... Oh, because we've only been playing for about 10 minutes, I can do another combat arena, right? We'll do kill count. Okay, this is the normal most kills win things. No, I want a private game. Okay, we'll just do this real quick. Shouldn't take too long, and then we'll move on. We've only got one other game on this disc, so I'm not super worried about running really long here. So we only played the Lost Planet for about 10 minutes, didn't we? Something like that, and I don't think we'll play the soccer game very long. Okay, so again, I don't think I have to worry too much about these green people. Probably want to kill some people with red names if I can find any. This won't be as much fun for me as Infection, honestly. There's no way it could be, just because Infection had the skeletons, which makes everything way, way better. Let's see, did I get a kill? Did I kill a git? I can't see this person. Okay. Man. I like her stupid outfits. I don't know why they look really funny to me. But there I go. It's not as great when you're a person, but whatever. I guess, okay, and then I just come back here and I can... I don't know, do these just drop into different places? Or is it automatic? Okay, I thought I had teleported by walking to one of these corners earlier, but I guess... I was mistaken, it's just a time thing. Okay, now I just dropped down right next to this guy. Okay, make sure he's dead. There's a another red person here. I think if I can... I don't know. She got away, I think. Okay. I have no idea. I think I killed one of my own people there. I don't know what I'm doing. Okay, we got it. We got it. We got Jetman. Okay. Let's see. Can I hop on down here, maybe? Yeah. It only hurt a little bit. Hey! I'm being fired at! From... Oh, there they are. Jeez. Okay. I don't know. Oh, they got me. Look at me slumping down in the corner. Wish I was a skeleton. Okay, so that's my second death. Let's see. Oh, man, there was a lot of us in here for a second. So, let's see, it's 11 to 10? Is that right? Is that... Are Carrington and Dada dying the teams, or... I don't know. Okay, well, I'm back here now. Do we spawn back in the same place every time? That seems like poor planning. Seems like it'd be easy to exploit, but what do I know? I've never made a shooter game, or anything like, even resembling a shooter game. So let's see. I don't know, this seems like a good place to be. But now I don't see anybody around here anywhere. Look how quiet it is. Wait, I heard gunshots somewhere. I have no idea where I want to be right now. Is everyone just hiding? Maybe. Oh. Pist is on a streak of 4 kills. That's a lot. Hope I don't run into them. They'll kill me for sure. I suck at this game. Okay. Well, there's a bunch of my people at least, but I still know where these reds are. Oh wait, there we go. Okay, I found a couple of reds. Hopefully I'm not shooting my own people too much here. I don't know what I'm doing. Oh. Yay. We did it. Okay. Now, oh, no, don't kill me. I wanna win. Okay. I'm shooting this person way over there. I can't even see them. I'm a bad shot from a distance. I'm a bad shot up close too, honestly, but, there we go. Did I get her? No, she's still up. I'm reloading. Ah, dang it. Jetman killed me. Ah, Jetman got revenge, I see. Okay. Well, shit. I'm not going to play a huge role in the outcome of this battle. If we win, it's not going to be because of me. I'm trying to kill people as much as possible. I just, like I said, I'm not very good at this game, or really games like it in general. Just take me back to where I belong. Okay. Where do I want to go now? I don't know. Oh, that was probably dumb. Okay. Let's see. I don't know where I want to go. Well, I just went in a circle. Okay. I guess we'll just explore some until I run into a red, like that guy. Orchid. Let's see. Is that Jetman again? It looks like it. I can't read the name. It's too fast. Maybe I should have gotten a different gun. I don't know. I feel like this gun is not very good. I don't know how to change it. I can reload it at least, but... Oh, hey, it's Pist! Had the like, 4 kills... Nice, that was kill tactic. Okay. They're all so busy shooting each other, I'm just picking off anyone that gets in my way. Hopefully they're mostly reds. I think I've killed one or two of my own teammates here. But, come on, reload. Oh. Okay. I don't know, was that my team? I have no idea. I hope we won. I guess, I don't know, I'm assuming we won. Oh, here's our scores, okay. Dadadine was red, Carrington was green. Oh, we lost. Okay. I was hoping we'd win. Let's see. Where am I on the scores thing? Way down here, probably. There we go, that's me. I got four kills. Got a rating of 1, okay. That's fun. Okay, so, that's gonna be it though. Let's go ahead and we'll move on. We've got one more game to go. Next up here we have FIFA 06 World Cup. EA cranks out another fantastic soccer game just in time for the 2006 World Cup. Couldn't be happier. And, I imagine, like most soccer games, I'm probably not gonna be able to get into this one too much. I have nothing against soccer or any sport really, but I don't really particularly enjoy them. I'm not a sports fan, and so a lot of the appeal is kind of lost on me unless there's something more gimmicky. And the later we go into the more recent, I guess I should say, the game is, the less likely it is to have the elements that I find charming or that I like. I'm much more likely to like a really old sports game. Something made in the 2000s, probably not so much, because I'm pretty sure the focus on almost all of them is going to be on realism, or like a realistic portrayal of the sport, and like the physics and stuff. And that's fine and impressive and stuff, I just don't particularly care, and it's not especially interesting to me. Like I always do, though, I'll try to find, unbiased, I guess, opinions about the game when I'm playing it. Like, I know people probably don't watch these videos for my opinions, but I like to at least analyze what I'm playing while I'm playing it. And, so far, this looks fine. It looks exactly like what I pictured, honestly. I do kind of appreciate them making this video. It does make the game look a lot more exciting than I expect it to be once we're actually in there, thanks to, like, camera angles and slow-mos and things like that. It looks super intense. Nothing that we play is going to be like this while we're playing it, though the replays might look like this, some. But, oh man, that guy is morphing. I like that they're showing us that they have stock animations for every team. That's good, I guess. I don't know why they felt the need to highlight that. I guess the 2006 World Cup was in Germany. I had no idea. I was not paying attention to soccer in 2006. For a second, I thought we went back to the main menu. Those stars looked like the ones that they show on the demo menu. I thought maybe we got kicked out of the demo somehow. But no, we're just in space for some reason. Let's see, okay. So my options are the USA or Mexico. Well, I'm American, so I'll go American, I guess. Just because. But we'll do it away. We'll play. I don't actually know. I don't think that actually affects where the game is being played. But it does look like we're playing in Mexico based on this screen. It has the world's largest number of Spanish speakers. I couldn't read all that. It's hard to read this white text on that background. Mexico has reached the FIFA World Cup quarterfinals twice in 1970 and 1986, both before I was born. Mexico has never won the World Cup, I guess, but it's qualified. Okay, whatever. I don't care. Let's just go down. I like the zoom in, I guess. It's neat. They're doing a lot to try to make this feel exciting. There's a lot put into the presentation here. I can appreciate that. Even if there's nothing they could possibly do to make me excited to play a soccer game. I appreciate the presentation and the effort for it. Everything looks really nice. I like the crowd. The arena looks really cool. I like the flags everywhere. Feels very international. I'm sure it's based off the actual arena. Coach Bruce Arena. Is it Bruce Arena the name of my coach? Okay. I thought we were playing in the Bruce Arena, and I was going to say something about it, but I guess not. I don't know. Let's see. So, what are we doing? I hope I'm going the right way. I hope I'm... Oh, well, doesn't matter. He stole it from me. So, yeah, this is the angle I was expecting. Every soccer game has this angle. And I guess it's probably the best angle to play, like, to portray soccer at. But here we go. We get to see a little bit better angle there in the replay. Still not quite like the opening video. Like, once we started actually playing, everything got way less dramatic. Then, it was like, we had the intense opening video, and then, we were in outer space. We were in freaking outer space. And then, we, like, zoomed in super close into this arena. And then, there was, like, the dramatic, like, showing off the arena and everything. And it just got progressively, less intense from there, and now we are like just playing a game that, other than like the graphics, is basically indistinguishable from my perspective from like a PlayStation 1 game, because we've played soccer games that have looked and played just like this. I'm not noticing any huge differences here, other than that they are smoother looking. But that's really it. And maybe if I played more soccer games, I'd be able to pick up on more subtle differences. Or maybe even not so subtle differences. It might be really big things I'm missing. But once we get to the actual gameplay, for me, it doesn't feel all that different from any other one. And I think I've said that about a soccer game recently. I think we played one just like, what was it, last episode or the episode before? We played one recently where I said basically the same thing. Every soccer game I've played has been pretty indistinguishable from the others. And that's not true of most sports games. Like there's always similarities, but like most baseball games use different mechanics and feel differently when you play them. Most football games tend to be pretty different. Basketball games are pretty different, vary a lot. Not the soccer games. They're all like the same angle, the same pace. The controls are usually pretty similar, even though I never learned the controls really, so I still have no idea what I'm doing. I'm just pressing buttons and hoping for the best. Running towards the ball when I can. Hey, I got it. But, like, that's really kind of it. I don't know. I'm sure there's things I'm missing. I don't know what I just did there. I just decided to press a bunch of buttons randomly just to see what happened. And I don't know. But, yeah, I don't know. I've never made a soccer game. I don't even know if it's possible to make a decent soccer game that isn't like this. I really don't. I don't know enough about the sport or game design to say. I just know that that's something I've noticed more so than any other sports game I've ever played, or type of sports game. The only other one that might be kind of similar is hockey, but I think I've also said before that hockey and soccer games themselves are pretty similar, other than trappings. Like, the hockey is just basically soccer, but where you use a stick instead of your feet. Again, just from my perspective, as an outsider, don't get mad at me if you really like hockey or soccer. I've never known anyone who's a big fan of either sport, but I know they exist. Obviously, they're huge, huge moneymakers. But yeah, so this is it. How long do I want to play this? I'm already bored. Oh, did they score? Honestly, I have no idea if they scored. I still don't know. I can't tell. Okay, it looks like it did not go in. But okay, well, that part was a little bit more interesting, right? They like, we had the dramatic camera angle and stuff and all that. I don't know. Yeah, I don't think we're going to play this for too much longer, though. It'd be nice to get, like, one real score. I want to see some of those victory animations from the trailer that played at the start. I want to see some of those play out. Oh, come on, guys. Why'd you do that? So here's where there's probably some differences. I can do some changes here. I don't know what these mean. I don't know who these people are or what those positions are. I can do a quick sub. So these are some things that are different. I feel like maybe I was being a little bit harsh earlier when I was saying that they're all, like, every game, soccer game ever is the same. Because there was some different things there that I didn't know what they did or how to use them, but there was some features there that I don't remember having in older games. There we go, 0-0. Look at that. What an epic finish. I'm assuming that's the end. Match complete. Okay, yeah. So, we'll just go ahead and quit out. Oh, look at all this great stuff. So here's all things that I assume are new, to prove me wrong, things that I wouldn't know about or think about. I do like that there's 127 different nations. That's one thing I've always liked about soccer, is it's a lot more of a global sport than most of them. Like, most of the sports that are really popular in America are, like, just like American leagues and stuff, but soccer is worldwide, and that's gonna do it for us. I don't think there's another playable one on here. I double checked because it feels like there should be. It feels like it's hidden somewhere in here. There should be something playable. There's so many things. I don't know why there's a praise in the video showcase when we have all of these here, and we also have these features, which are interesting, but I think too long to end the video on. We're gonna end on something here, I don't know. Probably Viva Pinata, that seems good. So if you enjoyed this episode, come back next week. I don't know what we're going to play, but whatever it is, we'll have fun playing it together, and I hope to see you then. Bye.
Viva Pinata official video game spokesperson auditions take one. First up, Hudson Horstachio. Read from the script, please.
Well, sure, I do a lot of voiceover work. But I don't seem to have my reading glasses. Well, typically I like to get these things the night before, but I'll just give this a cold read then. Let's see. Get set for Viva Pinata! An ever-changing world full of endless possibilities, because this is a world where you get to call the shots. The pinata creatures and plant life that inhabit this land are all determined by you. Our story begins at a small garden that in its heyday was full of life. Mmm, heyday? That sounds delicious. Anyway, though now a bit run down, with a little care and consideration, you can restore this spot back to its heyday. With some friendly locals and basic tools to help you along, your garden tending begins. And from the minute you dig your first hole and plant your first seeds, you're well on your way to attracting your first pinata visitors. Then, depending on how you design your garden, additional species will be lured in from the wild to check out your handiwork. If they like what they see, these pinatas may even move in. And once they do, you get to create your own personally designed tag for them to wear, letting everyone know where they got their start. This tag will stay with the pinata wherever it may go. But your pinata parenting doesn't stop there. You'll also be able to name your new friends. Why, you can even deck out your colorful critters with all kinds of costumes and accessories. Now, if you want your pinatas to stick around, you'll have to give them a place to stay. And each of the over 60 species of pinata included in the game has their own personal housing preferences. Not only do these houses provide for a safe haven, they also provide for a private haven where two friendly pinatas can, oh, see for yourself. Romancing pinatas will dance the night away, and they're not shy about showing off their moves. Now, as your pinata collection grows, you can choose which to collect and which to trade. You can even go off and visit a friend's garden. To help you enjoy these more social aspects of the game, you can hire helpers from the local village, leaving them to deal with the more mundane tasks of your daily routine. Still, life on Pinata Island is never all daisies and apple trees. When illness or danger threatens, you'll need to be the one who comes to the rescue. So if troublemaking ruffians or sour pinatas pay your garden a visit, it's up to you to decide how to deal with them. Do you scare these pests off as quickly as possible? Or come up with a more creative way to rein in the rowdy rascals? And even when the coast is clear of sinister sours and other perils, you'll have your work cut out for you. After all, each pinata resident has their own little quirks, and sometimes they won't get along so well with each other. Tempers will flare up every so often, and although it's a pinata's destiny to spill its candy, best that it doesn't happen in a scrap with a next-door neighbor. Still, whether life is peaceful or hectic, this is your world to explore and ultimately transform into whatever you want. So feel free to change anything, everything, if only to see what happens. Of course, there's no shortage of goals to achieve, contests to win, and social engagements to make on Pinata Island. But it's also just as much fun to sit back and watch life here do its thing. After all, the world of Viva Pinata is a living, breathing place full of opportunities and unforgettable characters. So come for a visit, it's great! I mean, I live here. What more reason do you need?